for the state of Kansas, this is one giant opportunity for revenue, for enhancing the state infrastructure, for bringing in jobs, for increasing the number of industries in the state. There is so much opportunity. Well, a wind farm, you have a collection of wind turbines that are spaced over many, many acres.
It's a 250 megawatt farm. At the time it was built, it was by far the largest in the state. The electricity goes on to a transmission line which runs basically from Manhattan to Hayes. The tower is hollow and has a ladder inside, and with the more modern wind farms, they're finding that they can't hire enough technicians if they don't put an elevator or some sort of lift assist up there. The blades are essentially long, thin boats. They're made of fiberglass. They are basically hollow with a couple of ribs.
So usually you have running up the center of the blade is you have the main spar, and that sort of keeps you from being able to crush the blade. I think the easiest thing to do is say, well, if it spins faster, you get more power, and that's not always true. There's two factors in power production. One is the speed of the rotor, and the other is the pitch of the blade. It turns out that there is a sweet spot for a turbine as far as how fast it goes and what the blade pitch is, and it's that point where you're capturing power at the greatest efficiency.
You don't want the blades to go too fast, because if they spin too fast, they will spin themselves to death. For me, it's a no-brainer. This is clean energy that's free, that doesn't need any water. Each wind turbine brings to a farmer about $5,000 a year, and it brings to its county about the same amount in payments in lieu of taxes. It's a gold mine, and it's clean.